Hello everyone, I hope you're all doing well wherever you are in the world today. Now, The Empire Strikes Back is arguably the best Star Wars film ever made. And as fans, we've probably watched it hundreds of times. So finding facts about it you might not know wasn't easy, but I gave it my best shot, so let's go. The Star Destroyer we see in the opening moments of the film, launching probe droids, was an Imperial Class II Star Destroyer named the Stalker. The operation to use probe droids to find the Rebel base was called Project Swarm, and used 100,000 probe droids. Right, the Rebels named their base Echo Base due to its cavernous rooms and the fact that everything echoed. So it had like massive acoustics in there. So there you go. The white protocol droid we see hovering around in the background in Echo Base was called K-3PO. He was previously owned by a Clone Wars pilot and was one of the only known droids to have gained recognition by the Rebellion High Command. C-3PO hated him though. He was jealous of him and called him a dullard. Darth Vader's Super Star Destroyer and its complement of Imperial Star Destroyers were collectively known as Death Squadron. The large aquatic creature that tried to eat R2-D2 on Dagobah but did not like the taste was called a dragon snake. And this is what it looked like. The dark side cave on Dagobah became a domain of evil after a dark Jedi was killed there in battle hundreds of years before the Clone Wars. His evil energy was then absorbed into the fabric of the cave itself. The evil spirit appeared as Palpatine to Yoda, years before it did as Vader to Luke. Bounty hunter Zuckuss was said to have a really offensive smell. Nothing to do with poor hygiene or lack of deodorant. This was due to his rebreather emitting his homeworld's toxic atmosphere. Did you know the number of stripes and colour on an X-Wing's wing, or S-foil, or whatever you want to call it, signifies its call sign? In this case, red 5. There you go. Lando's right-hand man and head of security, Lobot, lost his ability to speak after acquiring his cybernetic implants. It was also initially used by the Empire to run battlefield calculations until Lando rescued him. During the movie, Lando makes a quick reference to the Mining Guild. Now, the Mining Guild have got the best TIE fighters out of any TIE fighter made ever, and this is one of them. Am I wrong? Is that not the best TIE fighter you've ever seen? Or am I wrong? Comment section, tell me the one you think's best. I have to mention Wilrow Hood, because you can't do an Empire Strikes Back list and not mention him. But we do have some new information. You know, he's ice cream maker. It's got a name, thanks to The Mandalorian, and it's called a Camtono, apparently. I hope there's at least a few there you didn't know, and if you did, let me know in the comments which ones you knew, which ones you didn't. So take care, guys, and I'll see you on the next one. Thanks very much.